Morning guys, today is day, I have no idea. So yeah, I've lost track of the days. I know it's a Monday, I know the sun's out. I know I've lost my sunglasses because the sun's out. I know I'm starting at Lizard Point and I'm heading to somewhere, Porthallow, I think. There may or may not be a campsite there. Somewhere around the Lizard towards Halford Passage is the plan for today. It's about a 15er. Left about 8. It took me a minute to download all the OS maps and things. I was ready earlier, but hey, have a look at this over my shoulder. Ooh, wrong way. Come on, gimbal. That's it. Beautiful. So yeah, shots of Lizard Point and Lizard Lighthouse coming up about now. Shaping up to be a good morning. Absolutely stunning views. There we go, there's the lighthouse. Stunning start to the day. Cove looks beautiful. That kind of turquoisey blue. stand there in the path. Yep. Hello. Where are you going? Just barge me out of the way. Today it's lunchtime at Kennock Sands. Still got 5 miles to go to Coverack, and then still probably another 3.5 past there to Porthallow. Oh, got to get a move on. Big drop down cove. So the majority of the day has sort of been like this, sort of overgrown cliff edge paths. Gotta go all the way down there. Make it out, there's steps all the way up there. That's going to be brutal. Steps are never ending. Heart attack hill. Oh, absolutely. This is like back, yeah, being in North Devon or North Cornwall. Oh, it's a trudge. Oh, this is an impressive hill. Oh man, will it end? It must end soon. Oh, I see a false summit. So the real name for Heart Attack Hill is Beagle's Point. Oh, fuck you, Beagle's Point. Those big ships out to sea are empty cargo ships. The local fishermen at Cadiff were saying they're just anchored up there, waiting for work, basically to save anchorage fees in Falmouth. So as you're entering Coverack, the path comes to some sort of fork. Doesn't really indicate which way is a coastal path, but there's clear high route, which is a bit shorter, 1 mile into Coverack, or the low route, which is 1.25 miles, and if you take the high route, you'll come across this sculpture park. Thank you. So just passing this quarry section now. The geography again has noticeably really just changed from the big jagged cliffs. This side of the Lizard has gone to more sort of rolling hills with lots of rocks placed on them. So at the moment it's 10 to 5, 2.5 miles to go to camp. Hopefully we're looking at a dive centre that's actually right on the seafront, so should be nice. A bit of a walk to the pub tonight, downside, but very varied scenery today. So at this point here we actually wave goodbye to the coast for a significant amount of time. Yeah, we head inland through a few villages and kind of skirt a bit of a corner, but that's the official coast path. Don't know if they couldn't get right away around here, but goodbye coastline for a little bit. And now we're road walking. To miss that sign hidden away in the undergrowth. There's no sign in the village either, so if you get to that village, turn right. Really? I've had enough now. Alright guys, weird turn of events tonight. I'm going to try and stay at this place called Porthallow, which was a diving place, come campsite, rocked up there. Very odd, really desolate. Didn't look like anyone was there. Wide open, kind of bad vibes. So, pressed on to the end point for the day, Porthallow. Found a closed pub, heart sank, and then found that they'd set up shop in the community hall and had a bar and really excellent food, which was awesome. But still, no place to camp. Looking at wild camping, locals just advised us to come up a road to this place called Fat Apples, which has got a really nice campsite actually. It's getting dark though now, so I'll probably take a bit of footage of that in the morning, post it up in a sec. But yeah, unfortunately got up here, the place is closed. But yeah, we'll camp here anyway. And if anyone wants some money off us, we'll give it them. So that's how the day's ended. Long day, started really tough. The typical scenery we've had for a while, jagged rocks, ups and downs, and it slowly sort of eased off and landscape changed to kind of more rolling hills, but still rocks on the hills. So very varied today, you know, cliff tops, hedgerows, ragged, soft, all sorts. But yeah, definite change in the scenery. It's gone from really rugged to sort of, I think we're hitting farm territory now, and the plants are changing. Bluebells are dying off, heather's coming on. Not the most interesting section, not the most challenging section, but a proper kind of transitional section. So it's been excellent today. And tomorrow we're got some river crossings and onto Falmouth, so it should be good.